Another thing we get into is the disease cycle. This kind of gives you a illustration of a disease cycle where we start out with spores coming in at the beginning of the year. They land on the leaves, they infect the leaves, they land on the fruits, they infect the fruits. They cause the formation of a secondary form of infection, which is called conidia, which are going to spread around in the tree. But at some time during the lifespan of this, the leaves and the fruits are going to fall off of the tree. And as they do that, the organism completes its life cycle on the infected leaves on the ground. And then in the spring, when everything starts all over, it's going to come back up and it's going to do this again. So when we look at these, this becomes very interesting to understand exactly what's going on. And we call this format a disease cycle. In order to fully understand how you're going to control a pathogen, you must understand the disease cycle on it. When we look at the disease cycle, we see this little chart, and it's kind of like a little graph going to show us how it goes. Plant growth begins, and after that, you have what we call a pre-inoculation environment. So the plant starts growing. We start getting to a point where pathogen is going to arrive, and that's called the arrival of the inoculum. At that point, we have what we often call an obligate moisture period. Think of it like a seed. You put the seed in the plant, you water it, and after you water it, it starts to grow. During that time, you're going to get germination of that particular material. After the germination, you're going to get penetration of the material into the host cell itself. As you do that, then you start to develop the prospect of disease. Over here, this shows you a spore that is germinated and it is now penetrating in. Then we get what we call colonization. In colonization, we are talking about a post-moisture environment. Once the pathogen gets into the tissues, it no longer needs to worry about what the environment on the outside is, as long as it's not slowing down the pathogen and destroying it. So in here, it says we've got a post-moisture environment. During that time, we are going to get symptom development. You can see in this particular picture, you've got some symptoms developing on this tissue. Then we get sporulation. And when we get sporulation, that is going to cause the formation of inoculum that is going to be released, that will be dispersed. It will deposit itself back on susceptible living tissue, hopefully. We start the process all over again. This is a disease cycle. Anytime you've got a disease that you're going to control, you have to be able to look at these parameters and figure out, how am I going to stop these parameters from doing what they're doing? The disease cycle takes in several different parts. In the beginning, it said there was going to be a germination process. That's where the spore lands. When the spore lands, it puts out these little germ tubes. When the spore comes in contact with a proper cell, it's going to form what's called an apersorium. This is marked by this arrowhead, and the apersorium is where it's going to attach. It forms an infection peg underneath of it, and the infection peg pushes its way down through the cuticle and the cell wall into the cell below. One of two things are going to happen. It's either going to form a haustorium, or it's going to puncture that membrane and kill that cell. Haustorium, biotroph, puncture, kill, necrotroph. This shows you another one, and you can see the spore over here on the right-hand part of the photograph. It's a larger mass, and then the little tube coming out, the apersorium being formed over top, where it is penetrating through the host defenses of the cuticle and the cell wall. After it gets in, what we get is the formation of symptom. The spore over on the right-hand side up midway towards the top, you can see the tissue over on the side already coming discolored. When we get colonization from that, we get symptom formation. You can see the shiny little dark thing in there is actually the spore, the symptom around the outside of it, and the size of this is probably about a millimeter. Then it's going to start taking over and really going out. When we look at symptom development, there are a lot of different types of symptoms. The left-hand side shows what we call a tip dieback. The right-hand side shows a leaf spot. But in this particular case, it also seems to have some sort of toxin involved. Down here, we show a leaf spot, and you can see how it's got this very prominent purple margin around the outside. Here, we've got another leaf spot. Down here, this is actually looks much more like a bacterium that has gotten in. You can see that this is turning into a wet rot. Going to be a pretty nasty wet rot after it's done. There are a lot of things that can do this particular type, but you can see around how we've got these very circular type lesions. Looks like the integrity of the cell is falling apart. All of this is symptom development. We get sporulation and dissemination. Sporulation is where we get the production of spores. These were spores that were produced on mint leaves. They were quite interesting. This is a spore that we have that causes leaf spot on grasses. This is penicillium. This would be what you'd find on that apple. Or this might be the thing that you might find on that orange that got kind of green and moldy on the outside. Over here is another type of penicillium. These are spores of another pathogen off of grasses. This is another one off of grasses. You can see in this particular case that we've got the hyphae, and you can see where the spores are being produced on this. This is all in the sporulation and dissemination part of the pathogen.